Hi, welcome to my channel, the Machine Learning Engineer. Today I will introduce you a very useful tool which will help you in some situations where you want to do a demo in Google Colab and you want to share, for example, an application with an endpoint using Flags or using Fast API. And well, obviously, you cannot serve directly the application on your Google Colab or in a notebook in Azure Machine Learning Studio or in a notebook in SageMaker. I have prepared as usual a notebook that later on I will post to the repository, and the tool itself is AG arrow key. Okay, sorry. And then what is this? It's a reverse proxy that was globally distributed. And the way that it works is just, well, when you try to run an application server like Fast API or Flags, finally this server is running in your local host in a port, let's say like Flags in the port 5000, and what NGROK is gonna do is route all this traffic through HTTP or HTTPS port, which is 80 or 443, usually 443, to encrypt the communication and create an endpoint with an address on NGROK infrastructure, where you will be able to query your endpoint. So the port, you can use this tool not only to serve HTTP or HTTPS, you can also serve an arbitrary port, like TCP port, like SSH or others. And it's quite convenient when you have, for example, no infrastructure or you don't have infrastructure with a GPU like for example a A100 like you had in Google Colab, or even powerful like you can have in a cluster or a server running on the cloud. Something that you can be running in Azure Machine Learning Studio or notebooks, or in SageMaker notebooks, no? Or Vertex AI as well notebooks. You may have there a server which is running, for example, JupyterLab or Jupyter Notebook, but you can make run the Flags application there, but you cannot access to this. Server from outside, and then you cannot even test it. What you can do in that case, in order to take advantage of that infrastructure that may have connection or access to a powerful GPU, and you want to test your inference point, is use this application to route all this traffic through this tunnel, and you will be able in that case to test the application. Well, you can get take a look to the documentation. I will post in the notebook how it works. You had to create an account in NG arrow key, and there is a free account that gives you at least to test and something more than to test everything that you need. You had also pay as you go service, which obviously gives you more. But with the free account, at least for this test, you will be able to test and to do all the experiments that you want. No? You can see the application is quite complex. If you want to understand how it's working under the hood, you may need to have some networking knowledge, how the TCP/IP stack work and how the routing work, how you can how a reverse proxy is working and some other concepts, but it's not, well, it's very simple to use. You can have agents that run as in the in different operating system, even in a Raspberry Pi. You have different SDKs. We will try today Python SDK to do this small test, and even you can run this in a Kubernetes cluster. So again, you have here available your tokens once you create the application, but there is many other things that you can do, specify even your certificates or SSH public keys, many things. Again, depending the or your use case, look at the documentation and you will find a solution. Some of these options are only available on the public, pay as you go account. But well, for this test, and then if you need to do something similar to what you are gonna see here, is enough with the free account, just to do a demo or to do some testing or something that you only can run, for example, in a you cannot run it in your PC. But you can run it in your in a Google Colab because you have access like here at to a GPU T4 with 16 gigabytes or to a A100 if you have a pro account, and then you can create your inference point and load your model in that inference point and do some testing and verify that the application is working properly. We will look at this now. So this notebook, I will post it later on. I will explain you now how it works. Okay, so we install these two libraries, Flux and PyNGRoKey. Yeah, we have installed it. We just import the scripts, and then on we just import here from the PyNGRoKey library, the conf and the client. So, and open also sockets to later on start a thread. And then you can either get this, the authentication token, just getting, requesting to this IP, to this link, or as I did it here, is just getting from your secrets here in Colab. You start create a Flux application. Here we are just connecting the port 5000. Port 5000 by default is where Flux API, Flux library start to run the application server. And here what we are doing is just connecting the port 500,000 to the public underscore URL. If you have a private endpoint here, you need to change this for your specific endpoint. But here what we do again, we connect the endpoint to the public IP address, and then on what we are gonna do here is redirect all the traffic to the all the traffic that is the directed in and out to the port 5000 to another port and an arbitrary port listening in this public URL. And then sorry, this public URL is listening in the port 443. And then this way you expose the port 5000 in your local host name in a public IP address listening in the port 443 and 80. Okay, that is the connection. Here we just print what we had. You will see here. And here we had the, and here what we do is just set up the public URL as in the config of the Flux application, and just we create here an endpoint in the root of the Flux on your application ipproot slash, and then we executing when we hit this entry point, we will just execute, we will get the host name of the server where is collat notebook is running, and we will return it in a string. in the last line, we are just creating a thread where it's going to run our application server. We execute it, and then on, here we obtain this URL, and then on here we are sending this, everything that you send to this URL. Now the endpoint that we define is only a GET by default, so just hitting the address, you will receive this warning, you receive the message. So check here the hostname. If you write here hostname, you get the same, no? So this is telling you that we are. Just imagine this is very simple example, but imagine that here in this endpoint you had you create a post endpoint, you or a get endpoint, and here you had the logic to load an ML model which need your GPU, or the GPU that you can connect in your Google Colab, and you can create an inference point easily served by a Flash or Fast API. For Fast API it will be exactly the same. For those that are familiar with Fast API, the process is exactly the same. And you can run as well in a thread or whatever. The question is here, what we are doing with this tunnel technology is just routing the everything that is in and out to the port 5000 in localhost is exposed in a public IP address on the infrastructure of NGROK. That's all. I hope that you like it. Very useful tool in some use cases. In some, it can help you a lot. Again, it's a complex tool. It had many options, but again, probably it's worth it to spend a couple of hours just to read the documentation and see what is able to do this tool, and have it in mind for any presentation or test that you want to do before. Release an application, or before to do a demo, you want to, or just to present a demo or something that you are doing. Okay, that's all. I hope you like it. Thank you very much for watching this video. And as I say usually, if you like the video, give me a like and subscribe to the channel if you didn't do it before. Thank you.